If She Feared, A Kate Wise Mystery, Book 6. Written by Blake Pierce and narrated by Quinn Francis. Prologue. When Tamara Bateman walked into the two-story house at 3:30 in the afternoon, she was reminded of why she loved her job so much. As a real estate agent in Estes, Delaware, she saw at least 4 new houses a week. Most of the time, those homes were so-so at best, carbon copies of other homes in the area, usually with a price tag somewhere in the upper 400,000s. But every now and then, she'd step into a house and get a sort of tingle, a feeling that this house was going to make an exceptional home for someone. The house at 157 Hammermill Street was one of those homes. It wasn't a brand new build like some of the houses she had shown this week, but it was new enough. Built in 2005, and only lived in by a married couple with no kids before being sold to a property owner who fixed it up even more, it still had that new home smell. Of course, that had a lot to do with the immaculate cleaning job the hired cleaners had done. It was a gorgeous house. All of the floors had been polished, there was a fresh coat of paint on every wall, and the picture windows that looked out onto the garden in the backyard were to die for. With a touch of a professional stager and some modern furniture, the place would go quickly and make a great home. Tamara had been showing it for 2 weeks now, and while there was some general interest, there had not yet been a legitimate offer. With no furniture and having recently been cleaned spotless, it was essentially a blank canvas. But she was also starting to wonder if the lack of furnishings was what was hurting it. She took out her phone and started taking notes, trying to improve the public listing. She knew there was no real science to writing the copy on the sell sheets, but she enjoyed doing it. She felt she had a knack for it, almost as if she was a weird sort of poet. And since she had 2 showings tomorrow, she wanted to make sure she was presenting it in its best light. She walked through the large living space, then the gorgeous kitchen with its farmhouse sink and industrial-looking bar stools, as she was trying to come up with a non-mundane word for the marble countertops. She heard something move upstairs. It was just a slight shuffling, barely there at all, but definitely there. She cocked her head and listened for the noise again, and sure enough, there it was. The noise was not footsteps, but softer. She imagined one of the windows opened, the light autumn breeze outside blowing the curtains. That was almost exactly what it sounded like. But she didn't think anyone had been in here for 2 or 3 days, and the only people who had keys to the place right now were herself and the contractor. She almost decided to ignore it, but then it came again. This time, she was almost certain the sound was the rustling of curtains, but she could not see the contractor coming through and opening a window, much less opening it and leaving it open. She instantly tried to recall if it had rained in the past 3 days. She didn't think so, but even if not, there were all kinds of birds and insects that could fly in. Irritated, Tamara marched back through the living area and to the staircase that led to the 2nd floor. As she climbed the steps, she rolled through phrases in her head to explain how wide and spacious the stairs were. Before she reached the top of the stairs, she heard the noise again. This time, it was louder and more constant. And now, she wasn't so sure it was the shuffling of curtains. Now, it did sound like footsteps. But that made no sense. Only the owner and the contractor, a 56-year-old man named Bob, had the other key, and he was in New York right now, enjoying a show with his wife. Tamara knew this because he had griped about it the last time they had seen one another, and the owner never bothered with any of his houses once they were listed by the real estate agency. So who the hell is up there? She surprised herself when she took a few more steps up. She was only 2 stairs shy of the 2nd floor hallway. She could see the carpet and the bottoms of the first 2 open doors along the hall. She nearly called out, but thought that would be stupid. If there was someone here, maybe it would benefit her for them to not know she was there. "Don't be stupid," she told herself. There's nothing in this house to steal. If there is anyone here, it's either Bob or some nosy neighbor. And if they got in, that means the contractor left the door unlocked like an idiot. Wouldn't be the first time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.